Thanks for joining me. I'm creating a couple of workshops coming up that have to do with pick your own adventure, participant directed learning experiences. And one of the tips and options is to build into your slide deck a way to skip ahead. So if you gave your participants the option to pick this topic or this topic to start with, you can build that in. If you'd like to know, find out how you can do that, just keep watching. I'm going to show you how to set up a hyperlink within your PowerPoint presentation so that I can give the option. This is a workshop that I'm creating and working on. And at this point, I want to give my participants the option of either jumping to activity ideas or jumping to the tech tips, depending on what they prefer for me to start with. Now, I might end up covering both anyways, but what I do is I am just going to pick a little shape and I'm going to cover up activity ideas here. And then I've already written down for myself that it would really be jumping to the next slide. And I have to pay attention to this if I'm still building all the slides and if this number changes. So just a heads up pro tip on that. But I've got the box there, and I am also going to add, just right away before I hyperlink them, I'm going to add another box for the next one as well. Now I will make those disappear, but first with the box, so I can click on that, I am going to do a Control K. So I'm looking on my keyboard and Control is on the bottom left and then the K is about in the middle. So Control K, and what's that's opening is some different options. So if I had a hyperlink to a website, for example, this would potentially be a different way of doing it, but I want to stay within this PowerPoint. Let's just see. So I need to pick within the place in this document. And this one is for the activities and it's going to be slide 10. So, and it's showing me so that I can double check I'm picking the right one, which is very helpful. So I'm going to click OK. And it's giving me some additional information here as well, which is helpful. Now for the tech tips, that is going to be, again, Control K, and I need to pick slide 15 if my group wanted me to jump to that. So it's the right slide, and I click OK. Now, what I can do now is go to Shape Format is already open. And I am just going to make it disappear a little bit. So I could make no fill, and that's one way for it to disappear, no fill. And then, you know, that those boxes, I might want to make them disappear or I might want to leave them around there because it's also reminding me I do have this set up. As I hover over it, it is letting me know already where I'm jumping. There's different ways I can jump around to different slides. I can always cover some of those options too, but this is specifically to the hyperlinks, sort of mapping out if you had multiple modules in a large PowerPoint, and you can use this live or you can do this in a self-directed course that you're giving someone a PowerPoint. Now, what I'm also going to do is at slide 15 here, and I might be going through multiple slides. I still have a little bit more I'm building here, but let's say I have all the options. Now I want to go back to that if they pick tech first, and then I want to go back to the ideas. So I'm going to do this again where I'm going to do a shape And I can pick any shape, but I'm going to do this in the corner here. And I'm going to, again, Control K. And I am going to go back to slide 10. Because if I ended up looking at the tech, I want to go back to the event ideas. So I'm going to click OK. And then it's really kind of mapping out your process. If I did go back again, so let's say we skipped ahead to tech, then we went back to ideas, and we get through all the ideas slides. I don't want to go through the tech slides again. So at this point, I would put another box here, and I would want to make that skip the tech and go to 17, let's say. So again, if you're adding to your slides, you want to pay attention to this, but Control K, and I would want to skip what I already covered and go to slide 17. And then I want to make sure I save it. So this is a tutorial. I'll attach a blog so you can see that step by step. And you know, you can watch this many times so that you can have an idea of how this might fit for your slide deck. Again, my name is Patricia Regier, and I welcome your comments, questions. Share this with others, and if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you can find out when the next videos are available. Thanks for watching or listening, and checking out the blog.